It all begins here on the loading dock. Everything from crabs to cement to seaweed to oysters pass through this place. From here, the food supplies are sent to the main kitchen, the St. Francis Hotel, where they'll be transformed into scrumptious dishes to fit all occasions. This is the main kitchen of the St. Francis Hotel, and here's their list of banquet rooms. We've got the Victorian room, Windsor, Oxford, and in each one of these banquet rooms is either a breakfast, a lunch, or a dinner happening today. Here's a luncheon for 10 people, a dinner for 500, another lunch here for 27 people, another one for 50. The Grand Ballroom, a lunch for 800 people, and that is for the San Francisco Symphony. Look what they're having, quiche Lorraine, lamb chops, carrots, and for dessert, mocha meringue. This evening there's going to be a great grand reception for about, well, they estimate 500 to 600 people. $13 per person just for hors d'oeuvres, but look at the list of hors d'oeuvres. Crab legs are nice, jumbo prawns, 1,000 jumbo prawns, I understand they go for $1 a piece, that's quite a lot. Steak teriyaki, duck, meatballs, oysters, Rockefeller, all kinds of great things. They tell me that 6,000 meals will be served today and tomorrow and the next day and on and on and on. It goes on forever. This is Hans Linz, and he is the executive chef of the St. Francis Hotel, the very top person in charge of all the kitchens here. Now, Chef, we are in the main kitchen of the St. Francis Hotel, but you have many more kitchens, I understand.
Got a total of 5 different kitchens.
And you are in charge of all these kitchens?
That's right. I have on every kitchen, I have a sous chef, some is assigned, and he's responsible for the direct service and food coming out of these different kitchens. But we also have, of course, every sous chef has about 4 to 5 cooks with him, and they are in their particular area every day, same place, same hours, and everything. I think it's a lot of work from everybody involved, not only the chef, but it can get into the service, the waiters. Everybody is associated with the food and beverage department. It could be the bar, the drinks, the wine service, anything. But as far as the kitchen itself, I think we're having about 80% of the workload.
Do you taste everything that goes out of your kitchen?
Maybe not everything, but I have my ways. So sometimes, you know, with the experience you get, you can see it on some colors or how the dish looks or so, and then I usually stop at the take it aside if it's necessary and correct it. With all the fresh vegetable and the fresh produce and everything available here, I think you should at least try and give your best to stay on high quality. If the quality is not up to par, I don't think that you will survive.
Well, it smells awfully good. This is the soup stock. This is beef and this is chicken. And they're making it that they can make other soups from it. But just to give you the size of this thing, I mean, here I am 5 feet tall, right? Look at this thing. Oh, it's hot, too. This is an enormous thing they need to make the soup stock. And it's, I can't help but. Mushroom? Good.
Okay, let's put the meat here, the broccoli, the carrots and the potatoes in the middle, and keep them all the same.
All this preparation leads to the big moment that starts almost like a race.
Thank you.
wait to get this job?
Yes, I had to wait about 8 months before I was hired, after I put in my application.
Why is there such a long waiting list for a waiter's job?
Because the money is very good.
Well, how much money are we talking about, Bruce?
I think you could make anywhere from $18,000 to $25,000 a year.
Even as this luncheon is still being consumed, preparations are underway in the kitchen for the next event, the party to be held in this same room in just a few hours.
A teriyaki will go one on this side, one on that side.